Hi students, I'm Sonia from Vidya Guru. We are starting a new session on current affairs. If you like the session, please press the like button for sure. Share the video with your friends so that they can get the benefit of this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you do that, you'll get the benefit of whole lot of exam relevant videos which we upload. The session is important. Stay put, watch till the end, because that's how I'll make you learn all the questions, because at the end the revision is going to be very beneficial for you. This session is in English medium. If you are not comfortable with the language, we upload almost all the sessions in two languages. One is Hindi medium, one is in Hindi, and the other one is in English. So if you are not comfortable, you can watch the Hindi session. We'll start with the first question. Ambassadors for Bharat Ki Lakshmi. See, Bharat Ki Lakshmi is basically an initiative by Prime Minister Modi. As Prime Minister Modi's initiator, that initiative becomes important automatically for you. There are two people who are associated with this and they have become the ambassadors. One is PV Sindhu and the other one is Deepika Padukone. As you know, guys know that she's a sports person. So Deepika Padukone and PV Sindhu both have become the ambassadors for the PM Modi's initiative Bharat Ki Lakshmi. Let's talk about the second question, which actually refers to the winner of Vijay Hazare Trophy. We all know that Vijay Hazare Trophy is associated with cricket. As we all know that it is associated with cricket, let me write it down, because some of you who are not familiar with it, I am writing it, the sport which is actually there, and this trophy is relevant to that. Vijay Trophy is given in the field of cricket and winner is Karnataka. Karnataka won that and Tamil Nadu was defeated. So don't forget that. I'm not writing the name of the runner-up basically. But you need to be aware. At times a question can be asked in this manner where they're asking you that Karnataka lifted Vijay Hazare Trophy by defeating. Then the answer would be Tamil Nadu. So the name of the runner-up is equally important. Karnataka has won Vijay Hazare Trophy by defeating Tamil Nadu. The next question is number one on ease of doing business. See, when we refer to such, you know, index, such kind of reports are there. They are actually, you know, provided. You need to understand that there are agencies which prepare such reports, and those agencies become even more important. I was saying that ease of doing business is made by World Bank. Ease of doing business report is made by World Bank. First number was given to, see in this report, New Zealand topped the chart. New Zealand topped the chart. So first number was actually given to New Zealand. And as you guys are expected to know the rank of India, and that is 63rd. So I'll be writing it in this manner, that India's rank 63rd in ease of doing business report. Ease of doing business report is prepared by World Bank. India's rank was 63rd and New Zealand topped it. The next question is ICC Under 19 Cricket World Cup 2020 venue. Please look at the year also. We are referring to the next year and not this year. We are saying that World Cup for 2020 is going to be held in South Africa. But which World Cup? Under 19 World Cup we are referring to is going to take place in South Africa. Let's move ahead. The next question is First Lieutenant Governor General of First Lieutenant Governor of JNK. So Lieutenant Governor, we are referring to, as you guys know, that JNK and Ladakh, they have become union territories. So if any state becomes union territory, that union territory is expected to have a Lieutenant Governor. We are going to read the names of those Lieutenant Governors. See, they are first. That is why they have become very important, both of them. I'm going to write down the name. The first one is Girish Chandra Murmu has become the Lieutenant Governor of JNK, and I want to emphasize, I was saying First Lieutenant Governor of JNK. First Lieutenant Governor of JNK, that is Girish Chandra Murmu. The next question is, Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh. Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh. So that is Radhakrishnan, Radhakrishna Mathur. You'll read the name as R.K. Mathur. I'm just telling you the expanded form of it. It does not matter. That is actually written everywhere as R.K. Mathur. So, Lieutenant Governor, first Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh, that is R.K. Mathur. He has become the first Lieutenant Governor. The next question is, new BCCI President. We have heard this news where they were actually referring to some sort of problems with the person, and that person is Saurav Ganguly. They have made him the new president. See, we don't have to do anything with those disputes. I am, you know, telling you the name of that new president of BCCI. I read that in newspaper. I'm just actually trying to relate that because you may have read that somewhere too. That the new BCCI president is Saurav Ganguly now. Don't forget the name. New BCCI president. I'm emphatically saying that president. Saurav Ganguly. See, our questions are generally, you know, asked straight away. So, questions are formed in this manner. That is why I teach you in this manner. Railway service to connect smaller towns to bigger ones. They are bigger towns. They should be connected with the smaller ones. That is why they have started Seva service. Yes, that's the name of that Seva. That's the name of railway service. That is Seva service. They have started Seva service to connect smaller towns with bigger ones. Sharad Arvind Bobde to be the next Chief Justice of India. Yes. Superannuation of Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi. He is going to replace him. His tenure is going to be over soon. I'm talking about Ranjan Gogoi. Chief Justice, our Chief Justice, Honorable Ranjan Gogoi. His tenure will end soon. So that is why he's going to take his place. Sharad Arvind Bobde will be the next 47th Chief Justice of India. Don't forget the name of him. The question is important and it will remain relevant for you till the time he is in power, as in he remains the Chief Justice of India. Satyapal Malik appointed Governor of Goa. You've heard the name of Satyapal Malik a lot many times. You are hearing it again because there is a shuffle in governors. In governors now, and it is still happening. So he has become the governor of some other state. He has become the governor of Goa. Exercise Shakti between India and France. You need to know the names of the nations and the place where this exercise is going to take place, and that is Rajasthan. So Rajasthan is the place where India and France, the exercise Shakti will take place. As in, you know, this exercise will be, you know, placed, will be taking place there in Rajasthan. Swasti is like Howdy Modi. Swasti is like Howdy Modi. We have heard about that Howdy Modi was conducted. We all have heard a lot about that. So now it is Swasti PM Modi to be held in Thailand. Yes, it is, you know, sort of thing which is being conducted in Thailand. Bangkok we are referring to. Thailand is the place where PM Modi is going to conduct this Swasti PM Modi event. P.S. Sridharan Pillai appointed governor of Mizoram. So, Mizoram's new governor. P.S. Sridharan Pillai has become the governor of Mizoram. The next question is, World Tsunami Awareness Day is observed on 5th November. We have heard about the elections of Haryana and we know that Manohar Lal Khattar was the chief minister earlier and he has actually retained the position. He has become the chief minister again. He is from BJP. But we all know that is basically a coalition government with JJP. So JJP's Dushyant Chautala has become the deputy CM. So I said that Manohar Lal Khattar has become the chief minister of Haryana again. And Dushyant Chautala from JJP has become the deputy CM of Haryana. So referring to Haryana and writing in short, Haryana CM and deputy CM respectively. The next question is, this is the news. Smartwatch maker Fitbit acquired by Google in 2.1 billion. So I was saying that smartwatch maker Fitbit has become something huge now because it has been acquired by Google. So don't forget the name, Fitbit acquired by Google. Okay, I'll start the revision from now on. Ambassadors for Bharat Ki Lakshmi, that is PM Modi's initiative, Bharat Ki Lakshmi, PV Sindhu and Deepika Padukone have actually become the ambassadors for the same. Cricket's Vijay Hazare Trophy, in which Karnataka won by defeating Tamil Nadu, number one state, number one country on ease of doing business report. That is prepared by World Bank. New Zealand secured the first rank and India's rank was 63rd. ICC Under-19 Cricket World Cup 2020 will take place in South Africa. First Lieutenant Governor of Jammu Kashmir, that is Girish Chandra Murmu. Radhakrishnan Mathur, First Governor, Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh. New BCCI President is Sourav Ganguly now. Seva service started by railways to connect smaller towns to bigger ones. Chief Justice of India, new Chief Justice of India will be Sharad Arvind Bobde. Goa's new governor, Satyapal Malik. Exercise Shakti between India and France will take place in Rajasthan. Thailand is the place where Swasti PM Modi is going to take place. PS Sridharan Pillai is going to be the governor of Mizoram now. 5th November is the date which is observed as World Tsunami Awareness Day. Manohar Lal Khattar, CM of Haryana, Dushyant Chautala, Deputy CM of Haryana. Google has acquired smartwatch maker Fitbit. Thank you so much.